Conscious Bites. Pregnancy side effects.
Hi, Miss Dietitian, it's me, Deborah.
Hi, Deborah. You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm feeling a bit nauseous. Can you get morning sickness in the afternoon?
Poor you. Yeah, it can happen at any time of the day. It's probably the combination of your body physically changing and the changing levels of hormones that are making you nauseous.
You see, I've forgotten what it's like to be pregnant. Alicia's 14, so I was wondering if you could help with all the stuff that I should expect.
So you're Alicia's mum?
Yeah, of course I'll help.
Well, I thought I'd have a coffee again, and then I felt queasy.
Smells from certain foods can be triggers, like your coffee. Spicy and fried foods too. For some people, it can be the smell of cigarette smoke, perfume or petrol. Morning sickness can also be triggered by hunger.
Ah, that explains a few things.
Morning sickness can make you tired, fatigued, reduce your appetite, make you dehydrated, and some lose weight. Morning sickness shouldn't last longer than 12 weeks. So if it goes on for longer than that, or becomes severe, then contact your midwife and GP.
Are there any tips to help?
Try to eat small meals, with emphasis on the carbohydrates like bread, pasta, rice, potatoes, and breakfast cereals. In between meals, try to snack on plain biscuits, bread, toast, ginger biscuits, or bananas. Cold meals, like sandwiches, don't seem to give off a smell like hot meals do, so that's an option. And obviously avoiding the foods that trigger your sickness, like cold, sweet, or rich drinks, caffeine, and alcohol. To avoid the dehydration, try and drink little and often. Always good to have a water bottle handy.
I do remember last time I was off tomatoes, but I'm not feeling it yet.
It's all the taste changes that we're going through. Not everyone experiences cravings.
My mum always reminds me of her heartburn when she was pregnant with me.
Heartburn and reflux is more common in the last 3 months. It's caused by the pressure onto your stomach by the growing baby. To reduce the effects, it's best to have half your meal, then rest, and then eat the other half about an hour later. In other words, smaller, frequent meals. Other tips include sitting up straight when eating, not lying down flat after eating, using pillows to prop yourself up when sleeping, and avoiding the foods that affect you. And then there's constipation.
Brilliant.
But it can be relieved by eating more fruits and vegetables, pulses, whole grain foods, and by drinking around 2 litres of fluids per day.
Are there any foods I should avoid?
Yeah, there are a few, like vitamin A. In high doses of its retinal form, it can cause abnormalities to the baby. So make sure the vitamin supplement you're taking is specifically designed for pregnancy, so it shouldn't contain vitamin A or retinol. And it's best to avoid cod liver oil, fish supplements with vitamin A, and liver and all its products, like pâtés. Remember, fish containing omega-3 fatty acids are good for both you and the baby, but you still need to limit the intake to no more than 2 servings a week of oily fish, as they contain dioxins and PCBs, which can affect the nervous system of the baby. Tinned tuna should be limited to no more than 4 medium cans per week and no more than 140 grams of cooked fresh tuna per week.
What about other seafood?
It's best to avoid shark, merlin and swordfish, as they could possibly contain high levels of mercury.
Miss Dietitian, Alicia's having a party on Saturday and I was hoping to have a drink, or is it best to avoid it?
Alcohol, like all food and drink, crosses from your bloodstream to the baby through the placenta and then into the baby's bloodstream. As it's a drug at the end of the day, it can lead to consequences. A lot of alcohol can cause fetal alcohol syndrome, where the baby can be underweight, have a small head, and a variety of behavioural and learning difficulties. So my advice would be to be safe rather than sorry. So avoid alcohol throughout pregnancy.
Okay. I remember reading somewhere that I might need to cut down on coffee. Or was it caffeine?
It's caffeine. The limit is 200 milligrams per day, as it's suspected to lead to miscarriages or low birth weight babies. But the information is quite long, so I'll text it to you if that's okay.
Thank you, that's great. Have you got any more texts you can give me?
Yeah, I'll text food safety and the foods you can have too.
Brill, bye.
Read them at your leisure. Bye. Where was Callum going in such a hurry?
Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed the video. If you want more information about the topics covered today, then visit www.conscious-eating-tl.com for free downloadable fact sheets. Don't forget to comment and like us too. To find out what happens next, subscribe to the YouTube Conscious Bites channel. You can also follow us on Instagram, Twitter and Facebook. We would also really like to know what other topics you would like us to cover. So please either comment below or send us an email at conscious-eating-tl@gmail.com. And so we can make more videos for the ones that you want to watch. See you soon.